Hey everyone. Oh, I was enjoying that, playing away there. Oh, here we are. Oh, there's a few of you on here tonight. How you're all doing, how you're all feeling. What a year. This is my sort of, my roundup I'm coming back on here for, just to wish you all the best, and just have a little chat for a bit. I'll just let a few more people arrive, but I'm going to try and save this. I've been given instructions how to save this at the end, so I'm going to try my best. All good. Okay, so where do we start? Well, we had a wonderful end, really, to last year. We had a new music out. It felt like it was going to be really difficult to go on TV and do all the rest of things, and some of them were, but we made the best of it, and we definitely decided that the word no was something we could work around, and we did. We got on, we did specials, we did no audiences were allowed, but we made real progress. We got new music out and it's gone down well, and it's now part of my set list. And then last Christmas, I started to write this album. And in this very room, in fact, at this very piano, I remember sitting down for the very first time. It was about the day after Boxing Day, in that really funny little period. I was sitting down just playing these two chords. I don't know what it is when you're listening to we had a lot of Christmas music on last year, trying to feel festive. It wasn't quite the Christmas we'd hoped for, but I just kept coming in this room and just hearing these. These chords. And that's when this started. There's the faintest light ahead, from the cold into your bed. Begins as the faintest sound, then from heaven to the ground, in slow motion comes the wave. Children's eyes light up again, from the silence to a storm. Hear the dream of Christmas roar, comes around but once a year, brings your most beloved near. In just one day the heart will heal, as the dream of Christmas becomes. And it just felt so like a big hug. Let the dream of Christmas be come. And that was it. I was off. I knew I needed to make an album with music like this. And so off we went. Felt like a positive start to the year. I know we went back into lockdown, we did some more crooners, but this album started to play on my mind a lot. And so the end of the year comes, and you know, if we want to see some progress, we got on the road, we got out in front of audiences. my band who sat at home for the last 2 years, the crew who've been desperate to get back into arenas, desperate to do what they do, add their magic to what we do. Whether they were lighting or carpenters or stagehands or riggers, or they all have a job. They're all part of the night. And so there's the progress in front of beautiful audiences. Oh my goodness, the tour was so good. It was so good. It really felt like, okay, we're making, this is a massive improvement on last year. Last year I was playing TV shows to empty auditoriums with TVs on the seats. And here we are, a year later, we're back. And the record come out, and all good, you know. I'm really pleased with the response. And, you know, a Christmas album's one of those things that I think you try and breathe new life into it every year. And I've got a few ideas of how I'll do that next December, but I don't need to get ahead. This isn't an Insta Live to start announcing loads of things and bits and pieces, but it felt good. And in amongst all this, of course, we've got this other drama that's brewing. It's this new variant that came on our radar just as we were leaving tech. And, the one thing I was really dreading, because I had friends on tour at the time, the one thing I was dreading was, you know, I started work on this show in March and I've chipped away. And, you know, for those of you who know how much effort and detail I put into these shows, oh, I've given so much time to this tour, so much headspace, so much thought. And then my team comes on board, 3 or 4, and then that grows to the band. Then there's another 10, and then the dancers get involved in the choreo, and then this thing grows and grows and grows, and we gather more people. And so as we're in rehearsals in Birmingham, I'm looking at my crew of 80 people, 80, take a show on, like this on the road, all my performers on stage, and we hear of this new thing, that, and we're just thinking, oh my goodness, we might not even get two shows done. We might only get as far as rehearsals, and then all the implications that comes with rescheduling or cancelling, God forbid. I mean, it's mind-boggling. And I have to say, if someone had have told me the amount of worry and stress on all of us, I probably wouldn't have toured. I'd have probably waited. But we rolled the dice and we got out there. And bloody hell, we got close. We got close to fulfilling our full quota. Very early on, we had a small cluster in our performing. So, but what happens is, I'll explain it to you. So I was in a bubble of 4 people, and then the 5-piece band are in their bubble, and then the brass are in their bubble, the dancers are in their bubble, the lighting department's in their bubble. We're all trying to keep away from each other, and we lost 4 brass early on and a dancer. And this was about the 3rd show in, and I thought, oh my God, this is it. It's just going to go through us all, this. And this show's never going to happen. But we did. We got out there. We got out there, and we, as the nights passed, and it just seemed like the show was getting better and better. The audiences were actually amazing from day one, but I just felt as we got better, the nights got better, and we got as far as the O2, and I thought, well, here, this is it. We've made it. But we didn't quite make that last show, sadly. And it's hard not to focus on what you didn't. It's hard not to focus on the things that you didn't fulfill. We've not been on tour for 2 years. We were desperate to try and get everything done, but at the end of the day, safety, the safety of people, and no matter who are all the officials around my show. I am the head of my tour, and anything that happens to anyone on my tour, it's going to rest on my shoulders. And I was told it wasn't safe, and I have to take advice in places like that. And so for anyone who had tickets to come and see us on that last night, we will be back. We will be back. But we were beaten. At the last hurdle, we were beaten. But ultimately, the safety of everyone on my tour and the safety of everyone who comes into that venue rests with me. And we couldn't make it work. And so to everyone out there, be patient. There's a little song on an album called Beautiful World called Patience. Have a little listen to that. We will be back. Of course, we'll be back. And probably, actually, the next time I see you lovely people in Newcastle, I'll probably be back with the band by then. So just sit tight. We will come and find you, I promise you. And for anyone who feels let down, we're very sorry, but I'm also sorry that safety has to come first, and I'm in charge of people's lives, you know, mums, dads, daughters, sons. It rests on my shoulders. I can't do it. So that's that. We nearly made it. We got 99% of the way there. And for those of you who came to see us, can I just say this? Wow. Incredible. Like, we were so desperate to see audiences. And I was so aware, especially with all the media and all the stuff that was going on around this time, of how much people were giving us by coming to see this show. How much time they were taking out of their lives. It just meant the world. In fact, it meant more than any other tour I've ever done. We were so... I mean, every night I wondered, who's going to be out there tonight? Is there going to be anyone out there? Chaos. Brilliant, brilliant crowds. So we really, really loved the tour. We really did. And I'm talking for everybody. All we talked about after the shows was how great it was and how brilliant the audiences were. And my band were incredible. Thank you to all of them. Our brass were incredible. It was wonderful. And for those of you who've seen me before, quite a different sound for me. Loved it. The dancers were unbelievable. I don't usually have dancers on my solo tours. I'm glad I made that decision. Our choreographer, Lisa Spencer, did an unbelievable job. Our lights, our sound, our amazing crew who, you know, trawled around the country putting this show up night after night. They're just unbelievable people. And I know that we're all suddenly aware, because of what's gone on in the last couple of years, of how important these people are. But, you know, on these tours, I can't lose one of them. You know, they all do a specific job. And if they can't do their job, we can't go on. They're so important to what we do, and I'm just so happy with everybody. My brilliant management, who we've had so many lumps and bumps along this tour, we've all done an amazing job. Our record label, who've, you know, throughout all this, have been supportive and behind me. It's been a hell of a year, and I feel like we've achieved so much, we've learnt so much. And we go into next year with a bit of wisdom and a lot of hope. I've got a feeling next year is going to be a year of change. And it will be, actually. I'm going to tell you that now. It will be. Because on the other side of the person that you see on the stage and on these channels... Yeah, I'm at a little place in my life right now where just something's got to change. I don't know what that is. Probably something mentally. I've not been doing as much exercise as I used to do. I feel slightly heavier than I usually am at the moment. There's something in here that just needs a new year. I need a new start. Don't worry, it's nothing serious. But just as a human talking to you, yeah, something's going to change for me next year. I know I said earlier that I wasn't on here plugging, but I've got something fairly life-changing happening for me next year that I'm desperate to tell you all about, to be a part of. But it's something totally brand new. It's something I've never, ever done before and never dreamed of doing. But now it's all I think about. So I'm looking forward to sharing that with you at the early part of next year. But for now, everyone, I'm wishing you all the best. I really am. It's been so great to see you all. Thanks for all your support, all your lovely messages. It's a bit of a thing, social media, and I often have varying views on it, but in general, it's all good because you're here. The people who love me and support me and our band and all the things that we do, I thank you. And I've even gone into wine this year. Who'd have thought that? There you all are supporting me again. It's just wonderful to know you're there with whatever I want to try, that you're there helping and giving your opinion. It's brilliant for me. And that'll always be so important. And it's always in the back of my mind when I'm thinking of things, is that how supported and appreciated I am. I know all of that. I really do. So big changes coming, and I might report a little bit of what I'm doing and how I'm sort of combating, but I'm probably feeling like the rest of you that, like, this is feeling like Groundhog Day, this world right now, and I can't wait for the world to change. I'm going to change it. I'm going to change my world. And it's all in here, but there's a few little things I need to sharpen up on next year, and I will, and I will. So for now, everybody, I was actually going to get a Negroni in here and pour it, but it's in the house, so I can't. But I'm going to wish you all the very, very best. Please, everybody, please stay safe. Look after each other. I love these friendships that I see on here. Please look after each other. Be kind to each other. If you're going to be on here, write nice things always. We don't want any of that negativity on these channels. And 99% of us never bring that to it. But I hate it when people do. There's no need for it. This is a happy place for me and for you. So let's leave it there. And I'm going to try and save this thing now. This never works for me usually. But I promise you, I'm going to try and save it. So for now, happy Christmas. And I'm not going to go offline completely. But I'll be posting little bits and pieces from now and again. But not to the level I've been posting recently. And I'm going to try and sort through all my tour photos. And now and again, I'll just put one up. And if you can put yours up, actually, yours are usually better than mine. So that's it. This is it. The end of a year. Watch out for us on Christmas Day. We're on Strictly the Christmas edition, which is wonderful. I actually saw it today and it looks great. So good luck, everybody. Look after each other, stay safe, and have a lovely, lovely Christmas. And now I'm going to attempt